Hello viewers, SuperGT here. Welcome to another video. Thank you for clicking or pressing with your finger. Here we are. Group 3, the Nordschleife. We're going to have a couple of really rather drama-filled races. And I'll run you through my first race here, which didn't exactly go to plan. This is my first race, as I said. And I was a little bit rusty. And when I say a little bit, I mean a lot. So to kick things off, go for a nice little cutback on this Ferrari, probably the only good thing I did in this whole race. And then we lined up the McLaren, I'm driving the Supra by the way, we lined up this McLaren for the move, and the space doesn't really open itself up, but I kind of force my way in, and the stewards force a 2 second penalty upon me. A little bit later on, tried to go for this gap on this Dutchman, and he was having other ideas. Well, he was, but then I went through anyway, and we got ourselves another second penalty. Now, something in my favour, this guy had a nice little visit to the tyre barrier, and I gained a position, and oh, this guy as well, paying a little visit to his friend, known as the barrier. And then I sort of half-killed this guy, let's call it manslaughter for now. Gain another 2 second penalty. I'm not really gaining positions, but I am gaining penalties, which is not the name of the game. And there's another one. Not my finest hour, it really must be said. Tried to go past this guy, and well, to be fair, I succeeded. Half on the grass, half on the track. But tried to stop me getting past, I'll just get through on the grass. And well, here, trying to get through on the grass, not really a good way to do it, by smacking into the barrier. I'm guessing everyone's best mates with that guy called the barrier. Everyone's visiting him today. At the end of the lap, I have to serve this 6 second penalty. And let me tell you, at the beginning of this very long straight, 6 seconds is basically the equivalent of death, I'd say. This guy visiting his good friend, the gravel. And I go past him, up into fifth. And then we found our best mate in the Beetle once again, who, well, rather enjoyed skipping across the curb there and handing me fourth position. And then the Jag, having to serve a 0.5, we go past him up into third. So after all of that, it was actually a decent result, finished third. It was a very chaotic race. We started well back, 14th we started. So to go from 14th to third, after all of those penalties, not too bad. But I decided to log off of that account, jump onto my main account, and head back online, do some proper races where we must set a qualifying lap. That race we just did was an indicator that we do need to set a lap. Unfortunately, in my first lap, I completely overcooked this corner, which is the final corner. So you go around for 8.5 minutes, or just over 8 minutes, and then you ruin yourself like that. Good stuff. This lap, I went around for 6 minutes before ruining myself here. Well, half did, and then I came through here with dirty tyres from going on the grass, and then I completed the job by visiting my friend the barrier again. On the third occasion, third time lucky they say, coming to this final corner, slightly overcooked it, definitely cost myself a bit of time there. And as we come up to the line, it's an 8.11.7. Not too bad, definitely room for improvement though, as we saw in that last corner, making a big mistake. Okay, here we go then. First proper race where we've actually qualified. Just a quick reminder, if you're enjoying the videos, get yourself subbed, but only if you're enjoying it. I can't force you. I'm not gonna hunt you down and make you. It's up to you. Right, race number two. Let's see if we can have a bit of a better experience here and not visit our friend called the barrier. That would be an ideal scenario. Out of turn two here, you can kind of get the undercut. Very easy to lose control of the car there, as there is quite a nasty bump as you exit that corner. Not quite close enough to go for the move on the Ferrari, so I have to stick behind for the time being, but we're in a much better position. And I really enjoy this race because it's got a very interesting dynamic. Only two laps, but of course there's a very long lap here at the Nordschleife, plus the GP loop. 8 minutes, or more than 8 minutes, for one lap. And the thing about the Nordschleife is that it's very, very difficult to overtake around it. So a lot of the time you have to do all of your overtaking either at the back straight at the end of the Nordschleife loop or on the GP circuit, which we are on now. and it looks like we've got the speed here to go past the Ferrari, up the inside here, up into turn 10, slightly later on the brakes, and we get the move done. So that's a good start to the race, moving up one position, and we're going to look in turn to try to catch up with the McLaren out front, who is behind the Lexus in the lead. So sitting in third, that's a good position to be in, but I would say second is better and first is better than that. Just a quick 101 for those who don't know about motorsport. It's actually best to be in first place, believe it or not. There you go. Okay, so off of the GP, onto the Nordschleife loop. Here we go then. This is where the roller coaster begins. Very, very narrow. I mean, there is room for two cars to go side by side, but for the most part, you're risking it. Up the hill here, very dangerous corner. And I've run a little bit wide, as does Zocca on the exit. Check out his YouTube channel. He streams quite a lot. Right, anyway, I've got the speed, the momentum here to go to the left-hand side. I'm surprised he didn't defend it. McLaren F1 against the Supra, through the left over the crest, and there's respect shown. We managed to both go through there without anyone dying. And you quite often have someone going wide onto the grass in that situation. I tried to catch up with the guy in the lead. He was very quick. This is about as close as I got, 1.6 behind him. But he was very, very, very quick, and he ended up 4 seconds ahead of me by the end of the race. But it was a good result. You can see they're finishing second in the Supra. First and third using the Lexus RCF, incidentally, and that's what I went for next, as you can see here. Going for the Lexus. Usually always a solid choice for most circuits. Looking around the outside into turn one, there's always a possibility of a move. I tried to go for the cutback here, and I hit the bump and just over-revved the car. And we find ourselves in this tragic, tragic moment where you're facing the wrong way and the entire pack is going past you at the very start of the race. We've all been there. I go down to 19th and at the end finish 11th. Not ideal really at all. And my main advice for you is don't bin it at the very start of the race, because you're going to go straight to the back. And then you've got a very, very, very long race on your hands. Now, qualifying lap. Setting a 1:11.8 out of that sector there, that's a good lap. If I've got a 1:11 coming out of there, it's good. If you get a 2:15 on this sector, boom, I have. Okay, we're on a good lap so far. Still a long way to go. Onto the back straight. 7:24. That feels all right. Then into this sequence here, which I messed up on my record lap so far. But you see there, hooking up with the apex a lot better. We're back in the Supra now. And then it's just a dash to the line, hoping to beat an 8:10. What's it going to be? Well, an 8:10, exactly. Rather frustrating, because it's just really nice to get 8:09, even if it's a 9:99. But there you go. Can't have it all your own way sometimes. But it does move us up into second. If we kept our old time, we would have been fourth on the grid. So of course, second a bit better. We're going to ride on board with Dilster throughout the course of this race. And this race, this one is what the title is referring to. You know, this is where the drama is. This race, there's so many twists and turns in this race. It really is quite a confusing one. But starting off, not too much confusion going to turn one. It's quite an easy scenario here. Try to possibly go for a move, but we're a little bit too far back there. Let's go for a move. Spaniard here using a Supra as well. Dilster already passed Zocca in his Lexus, and he moves up into third. So now, as I said earlier in the video, we're just trying to find a way through, ideally on the GP loop, because there is so much easier, there's so much better chances on this GP loop compared to the Nordschleife loop down the hill towards turn 7. And the brakes, looking for the curb on the left on the way in. Let the car pivot mid-turn on the power as early as you can. Use the extra runoff there if you have to. On the hill up towards the Schumacher S, using the curb here for a better angle on the way in. Hint of a lift through the corner. And you do want to drive carefully on this race, because you don't have to pit, or you can pit if you want, but you're going to lose so much time. So you need to drive two laps on one set of tyres. You know, by the second half of the second lap, your tyres are going to be rather dying of death, and you don't want that. So you do need to drive quite smoothly. You do need to be considerate of that. So we've got a good chance here, potentially going for a move up in towards the NGK chicane, a little bit too far back, I'd say, as it isn't the biggest braking zone for this chicane. He takes it a little bit wide. I'm going to look around the long way round. It's, you know, I might as well try something. It's the last chance to really overtake before the Nordschleife loop, and it doesn't happen. So I have to settle into second. Now it's really just a case of just trying to keep as close as I can to him for the entirety of this lap until the long straight in about 6.5 minutes time, or 6 minutes time. So Dilster just behind, keeping things very, very close indeed. Now the leader goes very wide, and I kind of follow him wide. I just managed to squirm back onto the track just in time before Dilster goes through. So a bit of a hairy moment for the pair of us there, or for the trio of us. The three of us? Probably the better way of saying that. But we find ourselves in the lead of the race. A Spaniard, I don't know where he's gone. The Shadow Realm, probably. He's not in the top eight, so we don't really have to worry about him anymore. As we come flying through, is it Flugplatz? I believe it is. And then on this very long straight. Now this section here, yes, this track is very difficult to overtake on, but you can always get overtaken on this section here, as it is flat out for quite a long time. I covered it narrow. Dilster didn't quite have the speed. I know that the Super is very quick in a straight line, but the car behind has the tow, of course, and could always manage to get the slingshot past. But on this occasion, just staying ahead. Now this is really a scenario where you just have to keep your cool. The car behind, I can see him on the radar, bottom right of the screen, and by looking behind, they are right behind me. The pressure's on really, but you kind of just have to forget about them. Just drive your line, and if you just, you know, just drive the circuit, even at a moderate pace, a decent pace, they're not really going to be able to get past you. So you just have to make sure that you don't do anything too stupid. Ahiri is very close, but again, there's just no real room to get past them. To put your car in the middle of the track, there's nowhere for them to go. So just staying ahead for the time being. Looping round and then down the hill here. Easy to overcook this corner. Kind of just get the car turned in, get on the power nicely. And I think that's the thing about this circuit. And some of the times are ridiculous, like 804s, 805s, best times in the world. So I'm a good 4 or 5 seconds off at that pace. And I'd say the main thing they're doing is really just getting the car rotated and on the power really early. And that seems to be the key in this game, just on the power as early as possible. And you seem to gain so much time from doing that. Easier said than done though, of course. So we've got a very nice battle brewing up here. Zocca very close by in third. And Dilster, of course, just remaining nice and patient in second. But the race just brews up really. You're kind of just waiting for that back straight. That's where the drama really goes down. That's where it all kicks off, you know. So around the corner, look for this blue marker. There's a little blue line in the middle of the track. I don't know if you can quite see it, but that's pretty much your braking point, and it actually just gets you into that corner really nicely. So we've got another very long uphill section here, and again, it's an opportunity to possibly get overtaken, so you do have to be very mindful of that. At this point here, the Lexus of Dilster a little bit further behind than he'd like. Although, sometimes from starting this far back in slipstream, you can get a bit more momentum in slingshot pass. But you see, they just lifts off into this corner. The opportunity wasn't quite presenting itself. Over the crest, take this corner flat out. Take a tiny bit of grass if you have to. And then we're coming up towards the carousel. Difficult corner to get truly right, and I've never really got it completely right. I always lose a little bit of time here. Braking just on the end of the shadow of that tree as you come into the carousel, and then you can see here Dilster actually rides the carousel a tiny bit higher, and I think he gets a slightly better exit by taking a bit more of the banking than I did. So that's something for me to review after this. Go back to the replays and see exactly where I'm losing and gaining the time. Because my best lap, 8 minutes 10. Best lap in the world, 8.04. Now that's a big difference, so they're gaining a lot of time. Of course it's a very long lap, but they're gaining a lot of time in probably some certain places. And now we've got the very fast sweeping section. And again, it's just really a case of just keeping your cool. And make sure the car behind does not have any opportunity, which they won't if you don't do anything wrong. This really reminds me of, I think, of the last time I made a video on this combination. It comes up every couple of months. And it was a very similar scenario where a very quick driver was right behind me. His name was Super Euro Beats or something. And I didn't quite relent under the pressure. And I've just spoiled that video in case you were going to watch it. But it was a really good race. You should just go and watch it anyway. Right, through this section, looks like Dilster taking a little bit cautiously. I open up that gap a little bit. And if I can open it up to more than 3/4 of a second, that'd be ideal, because we are coming up to the number one prime rib roast overtaking opportunity. That sounded a bit dodgy, but I don't know. Just go with it, please. Now, a couple of corners left then, before the back straight. And, well, looking at the radar, straight back on me, obviously made a bit of a mistake. This corner, very easy to get wrong. You've got to be very committed on the exit. Very easy to just drift a little bit too wide and visit our good friend the grass once again. And didn't carry enough speed from that bit. So just watching this back, actually, and there's definitely room for improvement. Okay then, onto the back straight. This is the important part. This is where the moves are going to go down. You can see how close that Lexus is. But I do have the Supra, which does have better top speed. Look at the momentum though, nothing I can do really about it. And he's going to slingshot over to the right hand side. It's a drag race between the two of us, and he's just got it. Just look how close that was. Sometimes they run out of steam and they don't actually manage to get past you, but the Lexus has just got enough power to overpower the Supra on this occasion. So he's up into the lead. I just have to make sure he does not get away. I cannot let him get away at all. So coming back onto the main straight, that's the end of lap one, number one. One more lap left to go, so still plenty of time. I'm in the tow now though. And is he going to block it? No, he's not. So I might as well go for the reply move straight away here. And on the outside, he's going to keep it around the outside. And that's actually a very decent defensive move. I'm going to go for the wider line to get the cutback move here. And it looks like I've been successful. So I took a wider line in, got a straighter exit. Because this gives me the inside for this next left-hander here off turn 5. Which is actually turn 3 on this track, and I just managed to squeeze him out, and he's been demoted back into second. So that was a really good piece of driving from the pair of us. Really good bit of racing, very close, no contact at all, and we swapped positions a couple of times. So we find ourselves back in the lead. Same scenario again, just got to try and just keep him at bay, make sure that he doesn't go for the overtake. But as I said, this race was full of drama, and the drama's about to step up a notch in just a moment's time as we enter the Nordschleife loop, which is coming up. And through turns, I can say 10 and 11, but on this configuration of the track, they aren't turns 10 and 11. So Dilster's going to have a chance here. He's in the slipstream. It's not much of a breaking point into this chicane, but he's very close. I'm going to go defensive. It's the last chance before the loop, and we keep him at bay for now. Don't get the best of exits, and again, he's really close behind me. I'm just going to cover it off. Just defend for your life, essentially. And onto the loop we go. He looks up the inside, doesn't quite happen for him. And then through here, coming down the hill, and he's just sent himself into the barrier. Absolute shadow realm entry. He didn't really fancy sticking on the tarmac. And I guess he's got a good friend called The Barrier as well, and paid him a visit. So lots of people visiting Barrier today. He's very, very popular, isn't he, that Barrier guy? But that kind of thought, I thought at this point, it's easy. I'm 2.8 seconds ahead. I should be able to bring this home. I mean, 2.8 seconds on this track, it is kind of comfortable. It's not the most comfortable. You could still lose that. And by this point here, 2.4. So this guy was gaining on me, which is a little bit worrying. Now coming through this corner, this is my absolute nemesis corner, this one here, this uphill right. Just drift two wheels too wide over the curb, and now I'm visiting my friend Barrier. But funnily enough, the guy behind did exactly the same thing. The Frenchman did the same thing. So this German's going to come through. Couldn't believe his luck. Goes from third to first for free. Did absolutely nothing apart from just moderately keep up, and then just finds himself in the lead all of a sudden on his home circuit. Fair play to him. So now Dilster's back on our tail. We've been reunited with our good bottling friend, and the German in the lead is, oh, what is the gap there? 1.4 seconds ahead. So now it's really a scenario of, I just need to get into that toe by the back straight. That's basically the formula for this circuit. Get into the toe by that back straight, and then you might be able to overtake, or you probably will be able to overtake them. I think the BMW doesn't have the best overtaking, best top end speed, should I say. Especially if I have the toe as well in the Supra, I should be able to go past him. So I just need to get that gap from what is now 1.3 down to about 0.7. So I've got about 2 minutes to gain half a second. And that's basically the very simple mathematics of this race now. But we also have Dielster behind, and well, I need to get him out of my slipstream range so I don't get overtaken by him, as what happened on the previous lap. So I could go forward, could go backwards, could stay the same. Those are the three possibilities, obviously. But really could go either way. Bit of a squirm from that corner. Not the smoothest of runs here. But we are on the second lap of two, so the tyres are beginning to wear out. Bono, my tyres are beginning to go. You see here though, this fast sweeping section, not too bad. It's normally on the big braking zones and the really slow corners where you really begin to feel the pinch in terms of grip. But car not too bad at the moment. I haven't bottled it in maybe 5 minutes now, which is pretty decent by my standards. But we are entering the twilight of this race. Oh my goodness, that could have ended very badly. Just keep it going. And now Dielster very much on my tail once again. It's a familiar story from lap number one. So at this point here, it looks more as though I'm going to be losing position rather than gaining one, as Dielster is on my tail, but I am not on the tail of the leader. He's still got that 1.3 advantage now. Coming down this very, very fast sweeping section here at the bottom of the hill, Dielster just overcommits a little bit, manages to rejoin the track and not lose too much time. But you can see here, struggles for this right-hander as his tyre's a little bit dirty from the grass, and he just loses a bit of crucial momentum as we enter the back straight. So we will do in just a moment's time. And the car not too happy off of that curb. In fact, the gap goes up to 1.1 to Dielster now, 1.2. So perfect timing in terms of that. But am I close enough to go for this move here? The Supra is quicker. I am going to be quicker than this BMW on the back straight. You see there, Dielster just dropping off. So a very, very unfortunately timed mistake from him. The gap is coming down, 1.1. We're going to whip this forward. The Supra is definitely quicker. I'm definitely quicker than the BMW. You see I'm gaining slightly. Is it going to be enough? The gap down to 0.7 as we enter the final sequence of corners. Not quite close enough. I just needed a few more tenths and I would have been much, much closer, been in a much better position. Could we potentially slipstream past him onto the finish line? It's not quite going to happen. We're going to finish in second unless he gets a penalty, which hasn't happened. So there we go. After all of that, what should have been a win, really, I'm going to finish second. And fair play to this German guy for coming through, making the least mistake. Sometimes these races, you know, just don't make the mistakes. You don't always have to be the fastest, but just make the least mistake. Stay on the track when everyone else around you is visiting their good mate called the Barrier. And there you have it. He wins the race. Finished second. It was a really good race, though. Really enjoyed it. Really good fun. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, as always. Give us a sub if you did enjoy. Twitter and Instagram, all linked below, as is all my equipment, all that good stuff. But in the meantime, everyone, take care. Hope you enjoyed the video. I shall see you all very soon. Goodbye.